Moving on to the Sunday afternoon game. So much fun watching the Lions come through with that big playoff win.
Oh, look at that line
on Sunday night. We got the Lions and the Buccaneers. Also really cool to watch Baker Mayfield's kind of comeback tour here. Really funny interaction during the week. CJ Gardner-Johnson, who's just a piece of garbage. I love the Lions. I can't root for CJ Gardner-Johnson. But he made a comment about how the Buccaneers would be really good if they had a good quarterback. To which Baker responded beautifully with, "I don't think he watches film because he mentioned Russell Gage, and I love Russell Gage, but he goes hasn't played all year. Not sure he watches film." It's just in the way Baker did it was just kind of.
I like Baker at the end of it. He's like, so he might want to really get on the film. He clearly hasn't started yet.
He might want to really get a nice look at it. I'll start with this one. This one's really interesting to me because I'm going to be curious to see how this Lions team fares as the favorite. It feels like, you know, when like a team thrives as the lovable underdog who nobody's given a chance and the world's against them, and they kind of rise up. People are on the Lions now, and a lot of people are picking the Lions in this game. So now the Lions are the favorite. The pressure is on the Lions. I thought last week, even though it was the first home playoff game in 30 years, the pressure was on the Rams because everyone thought the Rams were going to win the game, and it was Stafford, and it was them coming back, and they're the better team is what everybody kept saying. So I think the pressure was off the Lions. What do they got to lose? They haven't won a home playoff game in 30 years. This one, I feel like the pressure is squarely on the Lions' shoulders, and that makes me nervous because the other sideline is a guy who thrives being the underdog. And I don't have the graphic loaded. I should have had it ready. The Baker Mayfield cycle of play really good as the underdog, you know, get a bunch of wins, favorite, then go back into the two. Like, it's just, they're at the point right now where
you go to a different team.
Right. He's right now, he thrives as being the underdog. And once again, this is kind of the storyline going into this weekend is I don't think many people are giving Tampa Bay a chance to win the game. You take Baker Mayfield and he is what he is. They arguably have the better receiving core as a whole. I'll take Amon-Ra St. Brown over anybody. But Mike Evans and Godwin and Cade Otton as a three-headed monster with then White coming out of the backfield, that's a good offense. And I think Tampa Bay is being overlooked in this game. It's 6.5 last time I checked.
Yes.
Spread. I think they're being overlooked in this game. I think Baker's a guy who can win on the road. I think Tampa Bay is a well-coached team. Who would have thought I'd say that after Todd Bowles' stint with the New York Jets? Yeah, I think they're being overlooked. And I think there's a pressure factor that is going to be live in this game. And if Bowles can find a way with his zone blitz scheme to put a little pressure on Goff, is what Zach's always pointed out. Pressure is kind of the Achilles heel of Jared Goff. I wonder about this game if Tampa Bay punches them first. So I'm actually going to take Tampa. I love the Lions. I'm going to take Tampa Bay to win the game. So give me Tampa Bay to win this game on the road, 24-16 Tampa Bay. I actually think they kind of control it for a good majority of the game. Will I be rooting for the Lions? Absolutely. I think that just goes without saying, but I think Tampa Bay is going to win the game. There was a reporter who asked Todd Bowles this week how they were going to fare in the elements.
The weather. That was quite a question. It was on. She didn't just ask it straight. She did like a 40-second soliloquy about other weather games and how the temperature in Detroit and what whether they are going to be prepared for those elements and what he like. She walked her way in. She painted a whole portrait of it, and then he just goes, "You know, we play inside there, right?"
It was the way he did it too. He's like, "Well, you know, we play in a dome, right?" it's the way he said it too.
He goes, "The only time they're gonna have to deal with the elements is the walk from the bus to the tunnel."
Which, hey, you might get cold. BMAC, what are you feeling like in this game? You think I'm maybe overreacting to the pressure that could be on the Lions here?
You're overreacting to some things. I'll say that. I think Zach said. One of you said the Packers ended up playing the perfect matchup last week.
Tony.
And it was, you know, everything worked out to their advantage, ended up being, we didn't realize it, but it was the perfect matchup for them. No. The perfect matchup for anyone last week was playing the Philadelphia Eagles. I believe 31 NFL teams would have beaten the Philadelphia Eagles last week. That team had quit. They were all done. The Panthers would have beaten the Philadelphia Eagles last week. The Eagles were all set. That was the worst football team in the NFL. I have no idea what that product was they put on the field. Oh my God, was it bad? On the other side, happy for Detroit. It's been a long time getting here. I have a little thing. Zach and I have talked about this. We've talked about this on the show. About the Bills, how we went through 20 years of them being the lovable losers, and you embrace their fans and you want to see them win. And then they won one division and they became absolutely insufferable. And they acted like they were kings of the world. Lions are doing a little bit of this. They're making me not like them. The team made me not like them. The fans booing Matthew Stafford, wild behavior.
Yeah.
Absolutely wild behavior.
What are you doing?
The Kirby Joseph hit on Higbee. Kirby Joseph, I would give him the benefit of the doubt, except he did the same exact thing to TJ Hockenson 3 weeks or 4 weeks earlier. Just a dirty guy. The couple hits on Stafford that were late. I don't know. Detroit, I didn't like the vibes of Detroit in that game. I also think they should have lost the game. I think they got pretty lucky. Not a couple times it could have been pass interference called that wasn't called that would have put the Rams right there to win the game. They also should have probably called roughing the quarterback on that play where Stafford.
Oh, the one where he got thrown out of a car.
18 times after he threw the ball. It was like after he threw the ball, you saw like seven more people hit him. And then he died on the field and they let him keep playing. But I don't know. All of a sudden, I didn't like the Lions so much. I especially didn't like the reaction to Stafford. I didn't like some of the behavior of their defensive players. That being said, no, the Bucs are not nearly as good as they appeared against that terrible Eagles team. The Lions are going to kill them. This is going to be an absolute cakewalk. This is a boring snooze of a game. The Lions are going to bloodbath this team. I like the Lions to win 31-6.
Whoa. Okay. Zach, do you think it matters that these two teams played earlier and the Lions handled them? It was 20-6. There's a lot of people out, but do you think that is going to weigh into this at all? Or do you think it's just a completely fresh slate in the new game?
Yeah, no, you throw that all out. These teams are way different. That was week 8 or something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, it matters a little bit maybe with some scheming or with some matchups that you notice perhaps, but no, I think once the game starts anew. First of all, let's give credit to both these quarterbacks. This is a redemption matchup.
Yeah.
Jared Goff.
Cast aside.
Jared Goff, a throw in for a Matt Stafford trade. He might be serviceable for a year.
Both number one overall pick, too.
Right. Jared Goff is fully established as you give him a decent offensive line. He's going to play good football. He's going to play good quarterback. He's still got his little Jared Goff issues with the pressure and some turnovers, but he's played great, and he deserves a ton of credit. Baker Mayfield, a year and a half ago, was kicked off the Carolina Panthers, and we all said, is this the end of Baker Mayfield's career as a starting quarterback in the NFL?
Yeah, for real.
Is this guy even relevant anymore? And all of a sudden, he's breaking Tom Brady records for the Buccaneers in the playoffs. Yeah.
I mean, I think I said it on the pre-shows back in the summer. I thought he was maybe going to lose the job to Kyle Trask. There was a quarterback competition there.
Only one of us of the four of us said Tampa could be a competitive football team and play for this division. It was Brendan.
Yeah.
He didn't pick him to win the division, but he said expect more than you think on paper. And he was right.
For sure.
The veterans have been good. The defense has been good. Mike Evans is still Mike Evans. But Mayfield deserves a ton of credit. It's really fun to see this matchup. The winner of this game goes to the NFC Championship.
Yeah.
One of these quarterbacks is going to be from the shit pile to the NFC Championship game.
And get murdered if it's the 49ers.
Well, Tony, what? Pump those brakes, buddy.
You think Detroit's getting murdered in that game?
Pump those brakes, buddy. I don't think so. Yeah.
Well, I think it's going to be Tampa. So
I think Detroit is a problem for the 49ers. But
I do too, Brendan. I do too. Let's break down this game real quick. Okay, you've got the Buccaneers, who are solid against the run. decent against the pass as well. The Lions, really good against the run, awful against the pass. It might not appear that they're that bad at the pass. They are terrible against the pass.
Can't cover.
CJ Gardner-Johnson, the most villainous human being in the NFL, who I liked for about 3 weeks when he said that Philly fans sucked, because he was just dead on about that. But now I hate him again. He's running his mouth. Shout out to Philly for one of the most hilarious last 2 months of an NFL season of all time.
I've never seen anything like it.
10-1.
Me neither. It makes no sense. It didn't make much sense.
And their only win was a gift against the Buffalo Bills with some questionable officiating.
They were for 11 weeks the best team in the NFL.
Yeah.
Yes.
And they were for the next 10 weeks or whatever it's been, the worst team in the NFL.
Point margin over the last 7 games, dead last in the NFL.
It's unbelievable. I've never seen it. Nothing happened.
Nothing changed.
They actually got healthier down the stretch.
It's amazing. Right. I mean,
shout out to Jalen Hurts, whose window as a relevant quarterback
had
is
a boo-boo.
Over.
No, he had a boo-boo.
Yeah, sorry, Jalen Hurts, your window is done. You're not going to ever be good again.
I don't know about that.
I'm having fun. I hate
David Carr was right. David Carr was right.
Yeah, can't.
Sorry, Zach, you were going on. You were saying.
Yeah. So if you look at this matchup, you see Detroit has a big advantage against the run. But Tampa Bay doesn't really care about running the ball that much. They've become a passing team. They did start to run the ball a bit towards the end of the year, but I think they're going to know that this isn't a good matchup for them to run the ball in. Rashad White's a fine player, but this game rests, in my opinion, on Baker. And what I've noticed about Baker is he's a very first-read guy. Now, if you watch that Philadelphia game, first-read was just always open because Philadelphia was just they've given up as
terrible,
a team.
Yeah.
So Baker shredded him. If you watch some other games this year, Baker's a first read guy. If that first read is there, he starts doing happy feet. He looks for a scramble. He's not bad at it, but I don't see him as an elite progression quarterback. I don't see him as a guy who disadvantaged in a game is going to will the team to victory by himself. Tampa Bay's defense is going to have to play really well in this game. They're going to have to be able to stop the quick hitting St. Brown, Amon-Ra St. Brown, Sam Laporta. I just don't think they have the ability to quite get it done. Yeah, so you can say Bowles is going to pressure a ton of guys. Goff's not great under pressure. I think Ben Johnson understands the script here. You run the ball. You hammer the ball with Montgomery and Gibbs. You work off play action. And when you know an obvious blitz is coming, you get quick hitters to Jameson Williams, St. Brown, Josh Reynolds. I mean, this Mellon may have had a point. Detroit's wide receiver core might have been a lot better than we gave him credit for preseason when we made fun of Mellon for saying they were the top 5 wide receiving unit. I still won't say they are.
But, are they going to give me Josh Reynolds 28 yards again?
Oh, my God. That was a gift.
Yeah.
Every time I bet that, it wins in the first possession.
That's tomorrow's show, buddy.
Okay.
Yeah. But I just don't think Tampa Bay has quite – I wanted to pick Tampa Bay. I thought about picking Tampa Bay outright. But the more I think about the matchup, I just don't think it's a great matchup for them. I think the Lions will be able to run the ball enough and work off play action to score. I think Tampa Bay struggles to score consistently. Unless Tampa Bay's defense is awesome and Mike Evans is dominant, I got Detroit winning this game. I think they cover. I'll give them a cover just barely. I'm going to go Detroit 24-17.
Yeah, you brought up a good point about Evans, too, and he can't be dropping the balls that he was dropping against Philly. I mean,
well, that's a one-off. He's a Hall of Famer. He won't do that again.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm changing my score. 27-20 Detroit.
Okay. Cool little thing about Goff before we move on to the big one is I saw a stat that his last 3 stops, so at Cal, in his 3 years, he took the Cal team. They were, like, atrocious, worst team in the Pac-12 his first year, and then by year 3, they were top. Rams, bottom of the NFL, obviously number 1 pick. By his 3rd year, he's playing in the Super Bowl. Lions.
Yeah, but it was his fault they were not good.
Right. Yeah. Lions, same thing. Lions, they were awful, 3-13 by his 3rd year. They're winning the division. And I'm not attributing all of that to Jared Goff, but I think it's easier for a team to turn around when they're getting a consistent quarterback play. And he is consistent. I mean, whatever you want to say about Jared Goff is you know what you're going to get from Jared Goff.
best stat from their game against the Rams. Jared Goff on passes where he was not pressured was 22 of 22.
Yeah.
22 of 22.
He's just consistent, man. He's consistent.
Jared Goff, it's very easy to coach a guy if we protect him, he will execute the plays. If you don't protect him, stuff can go real bad. But if you protect him, Jared Goff is a great quarterback.
Yeah. And the more I think about it, Aiden Hutchinson scares me way more than any pass rusher on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. So I'm starting to maybe lean a little bit, but I'm going to stick to my pick. I'm going to pick Tampa.
Yeah, by the way, quick note on Aiden Hutchinson.
He's a beast.
He's right on that, just like Brent was talking about earlier. He's right on that Max Crosby line between is this guy gonna commit a real murder on the field, or is he playing football, or is he doing football?
Yeah. He's on that line, man. He always has been too. He's just one of those guys who plays so hard that he almost he blurs the lines of reality.
Yeah, but I do still see him. I do still see a possible low percentage scenario in which Detroit loses their composure, makes mental mistakes, has some penalties, gets into a couple scuffles, and Tampa Bay steals this thing. But I think it's highly unlikely. Yeah.
All it takes is one Baker big passing play where Evans hits Cam Sutton with a double move, and then it's 60 yards to the house. And then Tampa Bay, you know how Baker is. Baker's a front runner too. The whole team will start to get.
I just find it hard to see Tampa stifling Detroit's beautiful.
Yeah, no, I hear you.
Yeah, they're not going to stop them at all.
They're going to stop themselves if anything, and we'll see.
Right,
if that happens.
That's kind of what I mean. Yeah.
I feel totally unconfident on three out of the four games this weekend. I am absolutely convinced Detroit blows this team out.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think it's in Baker or Tampa's DNA to really go down with a whimper in this one personally, but